There is no bigger slavery than doing what you want to do. There is no bigger slavery than that. And there is no deeper and more malicious slavery than that. It is not the society that rules us anymore. It's a free world and largely democratic as well. Nobody else rules us from outside, at least not perforce. We are masters of our own choices. We are ruled from the inside. We are ruled through these desires that we call as our own, these wants that we call as our own. I want this, I want that. And in the absence of an illuminated environment, there is just nobody to tell us that that which we think of as our own desire is totally, totally external. That which we call as our own want comes really from our body and the past and the conditioning and the influences. It is not our at all. But in a world that does not acknowledge the subtle at all, if slavery is to be acknowledged, it is acknowledged only in the gross form. So if somebody has yoked you to his carriage and is whipping you from behind, it will be called as slavery because it is a gross event available to be seen through the senses. The whole thing is very materially evident. So it will be definitely classified as slavery. See, somebody is pressurizing you, dominating you from the outside. The whiplashes are evident on your body. So all the entire thing is very bodily, very sensual, very material. And people will readily say, yes, 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 this is an incident of slavery. But because we live in a world that does not acknowledge anything subtle, it acknowledges only the material. Therefore, internal slavery is not really acknowledged. If you are being controlled from the inside, it is not called slavery at all. In fact, the inside is thought of as the real you, whereas the inside is the farthest that you can be from yourself. When you say that there is the outside and there is inside, the outside is outside, surely. But that which you call as inside is actually more outside than outside. But we stick to the so-called inside as our own. Oh, it is mine, it is mine. My thoughts, my feelings, my desires, my wants. That is what is called as the freedom to be a slave. Long back, if you'd remember, I had written that it is bad to be a slave to others, and it is far worse to be a slave to yourself.